Good morning, world. Here is Sabina. I live in Kyoto, but now I'm traveling in Kyushu. And I love this shrine in Arita, in porcelain kingdom of Japan. And also shrine is dedicated to porcelain, to kami-sama that helps local people to produce amazing porcelain. Interesting thing, the shrine is just in front of the entrance to the shrine, in front of the railroad, and the beautiful mountains around. And this is Tori, a symbol of entrance to a sacred place of Shintoist shrine of kami-sama, the divine spirits that are everywhere in this area, in the nature. And it's beautiful autumn, end of November, so the ginkgo tree is like yellow, so beautiful yellow, strong yellow color. And I'm going inside. I will need to climb. I already visited this shrine a few days ago, and now I'm coming back because it's so beautiful, and I wanted to record a video for my YouTube channel. I just started YouTube 1 year ago. We were doing some dancing videos with unemployed tour guides, Russian tour guides in Kyoto. We did 4 videos on this channel. You can see the train. I missed because I'm not driving in Japan, and it's very hard to get around Arita. So if you come to Arita, of course it's better to have a car, to rent a car, because local public transport is not very frequent. And even so, I woke up at 4:30 today, and I did some work on my laptop, but I was late for the train because I need to walk about 2 kilometers to the train station, to Arita train station. So instead, I'm doing this recording for you, and I hope it was for the good that I was late. So you can see the porcelain, how to call it, porcelain vases and lanterns. And it's famous shrine, Tozan Jinja, Tozan Shrine, is famous for its porcelain tori up there. So I'm gonna climb all the stairs. And before I go, just to explain that Arita was the birthplace 400 years ago, it started, of Japanese best fine porcelain, which is called Arita porcelain, Arita yaki. But there are few places where they were produced. One was in Arita, here in this town, for sale. So the craftsmen were doing porcelain ceramics for sale. And another place was in the village Okawachiyama, just 10 minutes by car, and more complicated to get there by public transport, but possible through Imari. The best way is to go to Imari by train, and from Imari you have a bus to Okawachiyama village. Okawachiyama was a village of secret kilns, because the ceramics there were created for shogun, for the elites, for the aristocrats of shogunate during the Edo period, which is 17th to end of, from the beginning of the 17th to the end of 19th century. And the shogun and his people, high rank samurais, lords of the who were owning the various, how to say, hands at this time. Now they are called prefectures. In Arita area, the ceramics were made for sale in Japan and overseas. It was imported to exported to Europe and China. And since it was so beautiful, European and Chinese masters started to copy Arita Arita porcelain art. Look at this. Because if you were in China, you can see similar, I think Ming dynasty, they had similar white and blue porcelain. And the interesting thing is that the porcelain started in China. They were the first who found and discovered kaolin, which is called also the white material for pottery. And kaolin was found here in the beginning of 17th century in the mountains around Arita. So the Japanese also could start making porcelain. How they knew to make these beautiful things? What you see now in front of me, it was made 400 years ago. This is a replica of what was made 400 years ago. How they knew? It's interesting story. Maybe it's a legend. Nobody really knows the truth yet. But the popular story says that it was one Korean craftsman, a pottery man, who was brought by the shogun from Tokugawa's efforts to colonize Korea. He didn't succeed, but he brought pottery masters to Japan, and one of the pottery masters, Lee Sanpei, I think the pronunciation of his name, he was brought to Arita, and in Arita he started to teach local people. Later they brought more people, and eventually they became a very big community of a few hundred people who did pottery here. And to Okawachi Yama here was also pretty secret. There were two check-in points in Arita where the shogunate was checking who is coming to the city. And if they are not related to pottery, they were not allowed to come. They were afraid that the pottery technique will be revealed to outsiders. So they wanted to keep it in secret. Okawachiyama village, they went even more secret, more secretly there, because they locked the village. It's surrounded by mountains, very beautiful place. You should go there if you come to Arita. Like, it's really, really authentic preserved village with many kind of elite feeling ceramic shops there. And there was like totally secret place because nobody was allowed to enter, and only people who related to pottery. And even the craftsmen in Okawachiyama village were given a degree, a status of samurai, which was very rare, right? Samurai usually were born and got their status by their family, because they were sons of the samurai. But in Okawachiyama village, the potters were pottery people were given samurai status because they were doing order-made special presents for the shogunate, for the aristocrats, and they were very special. And I'm standing in front of this beautiful porcelain torii. You can see the details. It's already can collapse sometime because it's broken. It's standing on the mountain, so during the typhoons with strong winds, it's very, very hard to keep it safe, but it's still standing. This guardians, lion guardians, are also made of porcelain, and look at the mountains around. Actually, if you drive around, there is no public transport, but if you drive around, you can see even more beautiful views around here. So it's really recommended to come here by car, which I don't have now. But before, my friend was here, and the owner of the guest house where I'm staying, a Dutch woman, it's called the ceramic Arita, keramiek Arita, like a Dutch ceramic. She showed me photos from some places she visited recently. It's amazing autumn, amazing mountains, a bit reminding me Guilin mountains in southern China. So I recommend you also to stay in ceramiek Arita. I don't think there are many hotels in Arita because they are not really working on tourism development here. Like, there are about 300 families who are doing pottery, and they are not into I feel they are not so successful in tourism development because there is nothing here for tourists, if not this guest house from Hanek, the Dutch woman. I couldn't stay in Arita. Also, there is no shops here, no cafes. She said there is a cafe. I haven't found it yet. Maybe there is one cafe in the whole town, but there is no food. And it's pretty hard to get around. So it's good. The best is to come by car to see this shrine, to see ceramic shops, to see Marukei. It's a ceramics, beautifully designed big store, and then maybe to leave to Okawachiyama and to sleep around Imari, or if you can book in ceramic Arita, she has a really beautiful house, a big house, and she has a tatami rooms and regular rooms, like with bed, I mean. So I'm sleeping on the floor on tatami, which is a bit cold, but she provides blankets, extra blankets, and there is heating, of course, and it's very cozy and nice big space. So ceramic Arita, if you come here, this gorgeous, beautiful porcelain vase and another guardian, and just everything is made by porcelain, even maps in Arita. Arita and other places made from porcelain. In Imari town, there is a bridge with beautiful big porcelain statues also, because all the ceramics which were made here in Arita and in Okawachiyama village were brought to the port in Imari. From Imari, they went by sea. The ceramics were transported by sea to Nagasaki port, and from Nagasaki port they were transported to Europe and China, and then everybody loved Arita ceramics so much they started to copy it. So Arita have some connections with Germany, with Dresden. Even there is a porcelain, Arita porcelain park here, with a huge palace like in Dresden, because of the relationship of European German Dresden pottery with Arita pottery. So it's really interesting. There are European vibes here in Kyushu because of the long few hundred years of history related to Europe, and European were coming here, bringing Christianity from the 16th century, then exporting Japanese goods, including porcelain. So this is amazing morning, 8:30 in the morning, very quiet. And this is torii, regular torii made from stone. You can compare stone torii with porcelain torii. So this is a story of Arita. I hope you like it. Please subscribe to my channel and I will be more motivated to make new videos from the places I'm traveling, because during the corona era, I travel all over Japan for my part-time job in tourism and also for my research. I'm here for my research. I'm researching preservation and tourism development in traditional villages, in historic towns and preserved districts. So this is one of the places I came for my research, and this is why I could tell you the story of Arita. Hope it was interesting, and see you next time. Have a nice time wherever you are. Hugs from Japan. Bye-bye.